What's up guys, my name's Timmy and today I've got a short guide for you to show you how to make a mesh or import a mesh into Cubicle and then export it for use in Popcorn FX to make some really cool custom Trove mods. So first thing you're going to do is either import your mesh or create it. After you've got everything created the way you want and looking the way you want, make sure that you center it in your scene. You want to make sure it's in the center of these two axes. And on the ground floor of the scene. The way that you can do that is either save your mesh and then re-import it, and when you re-import meshes, usually the pro cubicle will put it exactly where you need it, right there in the center. If not, if you don't want to do that, you can always just click on it and you'll notice the position thing comes right up over here in the info section, and then you can either do the math and make it perfectly centered, or you can kind of eyeball it and make sure it's where it needs to be. So once you've got it where it needs to be, you're going to want to go ahead and export it as an FBX. There is an older method using DAE format and Blender. I don't use that method. It's not really necessary anymore, but if you are interested in that method or have an older version of Cubicle, I will link it in the description below for you guys. After you are ready to export and you have everything centered up, you will export as FBX and you'll see these options prompt come up. Leave everything as default. I've experimented with centering your pivot and using the world origin as a position, but it just doesn't give me what I need. So I suggest just going ahead and keeping it on the center there. Once you have everything where you want it and you're about to save, make sure you remember where you save your meshes at. It doesn't really matter at this point where you're saving them at, just make sure you remember where it's at. So we're going to go ahead and save this as Griffin 2 because I've already done Griffin 1, and that's pretty much all we need with Cubicle. So for now we're going to go ahead and close that, and every time that I update a file in any of the folders that's on my Popcorn FX, it kind of hangs up for a second. So while it's doing its thing, I want to show you something else that you really need to do in order to get the textures to show up properly with your mesh. So if you have Photoshop and you have a DDS plugin already installed, you can use that. If not, there's tons of other ways to convert your image into DDS. I use Photoshop, so what I'm going to do is go to Open. And let's see, we'll find meshes, materials, we're already there. And you'll notice that there's a Griffin 2 PNG. Now that image was generated from Cubicle whenever you exported your mesh as FBX. So you'll see that's really small here. It's kind of, you know, your typical MIPMAP type format. Just go ahead and save it. Save as a DDS. And you could just see this is the options that I found that works the best. So if you're interested in using Photoshop, just go ahead and print screen or just pause the video here and just copy my settings, because they will give you the best outcome for your DDS. So we'll go ahead and save that. We've got it saved. And we'll pop back over here into Popcorn FX, and it's still taking a second because we just added another file, which is the texture file that we just created with the DDS. So we're going to give it just a second. If it takes too long, I will make sure to edit and cut this little bit out. All right, so now that we've got this popcorn working for us, we're going to go up to our meshes, find the mesh folder that we saved our mesh in. We're going to scroll down and find the mesh that we saved, which is Griffin 2, and we're going to double click on that. When you do that, it will ask you if you want to build the asset. Click yes. When you build the asset, make sure you fly over. Look at the positioning, make sure that it's flat on the ground, make sure it's in the center, or at least the best that you can do in the center of these axes, because it will mess up your particle effects big time if it's not centered correctly on the positioning. So after you've got it open, go ahead and close it, click save, click yes. And now I'm going to show you how to properly bring in the mesh and its textures to use within a particle, within a VFX. So I'm not going to be going in depth with what you can do. I'm just going to show you how to import it and set it up properly. And then you guys can go from there. I'll probably make another video that shows you how to use it as a shape, how to use it as a backdrop, and how to use it as a renderer itself. But for now, we're just going to show you how to import it as a renderer, because it's probably the most complicated out of the three. So I just wanted to show you how to get it set up. So click New Renderer, click See Particle Renderer Mesh. And then we're going to go down to Mesh Descriptor. So here's the tricky part. You're going to want to go to the folder that you've saved your mesh in. No, I'm sorry. You're going to want to go to Live, then go to Particles, VFX, Cache Folder, the Meshes. Within the Meshes folder, you'll notice that there's a new two new files with the ending PKML and PKMM. They should be named the same name as the mesh that you created. So go ahead and highlight the PKMM and drag it over to the mesh source. Now, you'll notice already that our shape is showing up, but it's black because the textures are not showing up properly. So I'll show you how to fix that. But it's important. You have to use the PKMM file, and it has to be located in the cache folder. If you don't want to drag it, you can type it in manually. It'll work that way. But other than that, there's no like drop down to let you select all file types or anything. So it won't show up for you unless you either drag it or type it in manually. So the next thing we're going to do is we want the texture layer, which is a diffuse layer, which has all of our colors. So we're going to go back to where we saved our textures, I mean our mesh originally, which was VFX, then meshes. And then we're going to want to find the materials folder because that's where our texture map was saved, and that's where we created our DDS. So you want to see a PNG image, and you're going to see a DDS image. Make sure you select the DDS. So you'll see that the texture is there, but it's still black, and that's because we don't have any ambient color coming off of that. So you want to just change all these to one to get your texture to show up normally. And there it is. You can see that we've got a whole herd of griffin heads just popping up every which way. And this will basically, with the way you lower this, will change how bright or how dark it is. You can change the tint of the color, different stuff like that for just editing. You can do some slight color editing. I would suggest doing most of it within your texture map. But other than that, that's pretty much it, guys. That will get you started with getting your meshes saved properly, loaded in properly, and get you started with making some custom VFX. I'm going to make another guide to show you how to save them to create T-mods because it's a little bit complicated. So I'll make that for you guys as soon as possible. And I'm also going to make another video showing you how to use the meshes and the textures as renderers like this, as shapes, which can really let you do some very cool things, and as backdrops that will help you just with positioning when you're making other kind of VFX. So hopefully this was helpful, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, smack that like button, and just if you have any questions, drop them down in the comment sections below. Thank you all so much.